Hi, welcome to the OpenMP workshop presented by the NSF Succeed program. This was originally a one-day hands-on workshop that you can view at your own pace. To get access to the slides and exercises used by the original students, look at the link below.
You can start with one. It's not a lot of code there. You've already stared at most of it, but there happens to be a copy in the Prime folder that you've got in your exercises folder. And try a couple of these scheduling options that I pointed out to see if you can speed things up a little bit. And I think you'll be able to. So go ahead and give this a shot, and I'll be hanging out here. I'm also happy to answer any pending questions you have. Please go ahead and get to work. Okay, everybody, let's pick up with our prime number solver, which had a fairly obvious, well, I won't say obvious, but fairly limited number of options available to you to implement. And this is the one that I picked, although, you know, the chunk size is something you could definitely play around with. I went with the default chunk size of 1 in this. And so, again, it's low risk. This has zero opportunity to actually break your code and give you incorrect results. The worst that could happen is you could make it run slower, which is an obvious thing. But in our case, with dynamic scheduling, with a chunk size of 1, I managed to speed it up a good bit. As a matter of fact, by a good bit, by a factor of 2. That's pretty serious speed up in my book. And it's just by recognizing, again, that this was four loops that did not have really regular scheduling. Each loop could have potentially a different amount of work, so it would benefit from not having it be committed to doing the same size chunks of iterations. So I sped it up by factor 2. Again, no risk, very little time involvement. I hope that's starting to emerge to you too, that the amount of effort having to be expended to get these big speed ups could be minimal. It's not always going to be, and the potential speed ups are unknown many times. But the amount of effort that you're putting in is not comparable to, say, refactoring a code completely to use MPI on it or anything like that. So this is, to my mind, some pretty low-risk stuff to try on a lot of codes. Okay, let's look at some random stuff here. I've stuck on the end of this talk here a couple of quick things that we didn't have time to cover, but I want to make sure you're at least aware of. For those of you that are C++ programmers out there, again, we focused on C, but the OpenMP spec has well-defined behavior with C++. Things work pretty much the rules are things work like you might expect if you understand how C++ works. So, for example, private and shared work great with objects. Constructors and constructor recall for private. Things get complicated with first private or thread private if you think about what you're asking things to do and where they're going to get data from and whatnot. So you want to look into those a little bit if that's what you're doing with objects. The biggest question from everybody, obviously, in the PC world, HPC world that is, obviously everybody wants to know how well standard vector works with stuff, because that's what very often, again, the HPC world, we're working with big arrays of stuff. If you're C++ and have felt it useful to turn things into vector containers, then the answer is everything works well and is safe as long as you don't do any reallocation, right? And push back and pop back and insert can do reallocation, in which case all bets are off. This is a disaster then because things have been moved around in memory. So again, if you understand at all what's going on, I was going to say behind the scenes, but really with how the containers are just defined to operate, you understand that that's a limitation. Iterators are allowed for even in the loops here, in the for loops, it can work very well with iterators, which is nice. It allows you to stick with your elegant abstractions, or at least your elegantly written code. Other containers are less likely to work. Again, it's common sense kind of thing. For example, a list. Which is actually a doubly linked list behind the scenes, right? Being updated by multiple threads would obviously be very, very tricky to implement. You'd want to just lock things down. So there's, again, the theme here is things work exactly like you'd think they work if you understand what C++ is actually doing for you. If you have greater concerns, if you look in the documentation, there are examples and walkthroughs and a lot of considerations are taken there to give you some hints. Get your head in the right place. However, one thing I do feel compelled to point out in general is that MPI 3 has dropped C++. So if you're thinking of this as the beginning of something that's really going to scale up very large, be aware of that particular point right there. I won't go into it further since this is an MPI workshop, but a lot of times this dovetails with MPI type of efforts. So to sum up before we jump into the very, very different directions of OpenMP 4 and 5, if it feels like there's a lot of information overload, that's because I have covered the vast majority of the OpenMP capabilities. We haven't dived into details of a lot of them because that would take a multiple number of days to get into to any degree, but you're aware of what the capabilities are that they exist, and you do know how to use it for real, the most powerful tool, which is the parallel for or do. And again, the way to approach things is you look at the big loops, use a profiler if it's really not clear to you where those are or what those are, how to prioritize them. You deal with the dependencies and the reductions, and you know how to do that now. And if you find lots of barrier time or wasted time or want to optimize things further, you now realize that there are capabilities involving sections, the tasks, the runtime libraries, which allow you to just control the flow, the code flow of a thread as fine as you'd like. So I hope you get the idea that there's a very high-level abstraction you can start with that can buy you an awful lot without a loss of efficiency. There's very low-level and uber-flexible level that you can take OpenMP to, and it's a smooth spectrum to get from one to the other, and you can mix and match. There's nothing that doesn't say you can't have parallel for or do loop implemented where it makes sense as standalone pieces, and you can't have completely different structures, have some locking going on in a linked list with OpenMP API type calls, and there's nothing preventing that kind of mixing and matching.